Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Thessalonians 4:9-12. Now concerning brotherly love, you have no need for anyone to write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love one another, for that indeed is what you are doing to all the brothers throughout Macedonia. But we urge you, brothers, to do this more and more, and to aspire to live quietly, and to mind your own affairs, and to work with your hands, as we instructed you, so that you may walk properly before outsiders and be dependent on no one. Today's title is Living Quietly and Working with Your Hands. In this passage, Paul commends the Thessalonians for their brotherly love, which has been evident throughout Macedonia. He acknowledges that they have been taught by God to love one another, and they have done well in putting this teaching into practice. However, Paul encourages them to continue growing in this love, to do so more and more. This instruction reflects the principle that in the Christian life, there is always room for growth. No matter how well we think we are doing in any area, there is always more to strive for, especially when it comes to love. Brotherly love is the mark of a true Christian community. It is through our love for one another that the world will know we are disciples of Christ. Paul's exhortation to do this more and more suggests that love is not a static attribute but something that should continually expand and deepen. In the context of the Thessalonian church, their love was already known throughout the region, yet Paul urges them not to become complacent but to keep growing in their love for each other. Paul also gives practical advice on how to live a life that honors God, by living quietly, minding their own affairs, and working with their hands. These instructions highlight the importance of leading a disciplined and responsible life. Living quietly does not mean living in isolation but rather avoiding unnecessary conflict and striving to live in peace with others. Minding your own affairs involves focusing on your responsibilities and not meddling in the lives of others. Working with your hands emphasizes the value of hard work and self-sufficiency. By doing so, Paul says, they would earn the respect of outsiders and live in a way that reflects their faith without being dependent on others. This is important because our lives are a testimony to those around us. When we live responsibly, with integrity and diligence, we not only meet our own needs but also set an example for others, showing them the practical implications of our faith. Paul's advice also points to the dignity of work. In a culture that often separates the sacred from the secular, Paul reminds us that our daily work is an important part of our Christian witness. Whether in our jobs, our homes, or our communities, how we conduct ourselves matters. Our work can be an act of worship when done with the right heart and attitude, reflecting God's character and bringing Him glory.